Some laundry. You know, I love grabbing towels right out of the dryer. They're so warm, I wrap up like just like I'm in a blanket.
Whoa!
Well, I got my laundry started, but while we're waiting for it to finish, I wanted to tell you a little bit more about the true story, the Nativity. So, last time we learned that Mary got a message from an angel. Mary is going to have a very special baby. It's God's own son. It's part of his plan for us to be with him forever. And guess what? She was going to have a baby. Her husband, Joseph, and her had to go on a very long trip all the way to Bethlehem. But guess what? They didn't have any cars. Mary had to ride on a donkey. Ooh. That doesn't seem very comfortable, but I bet it's better than walking. They walked a long, long way. And when they got to Bethlehem, there was no place for them to stay. There were no beds. The only place that they could stay was with the animals. In fact, that's exactly where baby Jesus was born. All around the animals. You know, it doesn't really seem like the place that the King of all kings would be born, next to some smelly animals. I wonder if that donkey knew that that baby crying there was the savior of the world. I wonder if the rooster knew that this was God's own son. I bet they knew that there was something different about that baby born that night. And as I remember about Christmas, I can remember that God had a great plan so that we could be together forever.
know what time it is.
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go down to the clubhouse with Ollie and his friends. Let's go down to the clubhouse where wonder never ends at the Wonder Clubhouse.
We can do
at the Wonder Clubhouse.
We can do.
Oh, hi there, friends. Welcome to the clubhouse. It's your friend Zoe. And I'm so happy to see you today. Doesn't the clubhouse look beautiful? I just love Christmas. It's my very favorite time of the year. My friends and I have been reading the Christmas story, and I've learned all about Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus. I just love hearing all about the Christmas story. So earlier today when my cousin Sasha and I were making Christmas gingerbread cookies, I thought to myself, I want to decorate my cookie to look extra special. So I'm gonna decorate my cookie like baby Jesus. Do you want to help me decorate this cookie? It's my favorite.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hello, Zoe. Who? Who? Decorating Christmas cookies, are you?
Hi, Ollie. I sure am. I've been learning all about the Christmas story, so I wanted to decorate my gingerbread cookies like Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus. I'm so excited. I can't wait to show my cousin.
The Christmas story is the best story ever told. It's true. And I'd like to share it with you. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through who? Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Oh, hi, friends. I'm Justin the mailman. It's almost Christmas. Are you getting excited? Me too. And so are these people. So many Christmas cards to deliver today. But none more important than this one. It's our story mail. Are you ready for the next part of the true story of Christmas? Great! Here we go. Okay, so the true story of Christmas began when an angel told a girl named Mary she was going to have a baby. And the baby was going to be super special because, drum roll please, he was God's son. That's right. God loves us so much that he gave us his son Jesus. Today's story is about when Jesus is born. Oh, I'm so excited. Look, it's Mary and Joseph. What's Mary riding on? Can you guess what animal that is? A donkey. You're right. What does a donkey say? Can you do it? Are you ready? Hee-haw, hee-haw, hee-haw. Great job. Mary and Joseph needed an animal, like a donkey, to get to the town of Bethlehem. When they got to Bethlehem, they needed to find a place to stay. Joseph knocked on the door of an inn. Everybody knock with me, ready? Knock, knock, knock. The innkeeper said there was no room for them inside, but they could stay in the stable out back. So Mary and Joseph had to sleep in a stable where all the animals stayed. Listen, what animals do you hear?
It's a cow.
That's right. What's this one? A chicken, that's right. How about this one? A sheep, that's right. What about this one? That's not an animal. What is that? It's a baby. Jesus, God's son, was born. Everyone do a whisper yay. Ready? Yay! Mary wrapped the baby all up and put him in the manger. Wow, the most special baby in all the world had been born. This is why we celebrate Christmas. Jesus, God's son, was born. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Tell me, why is Jesus special?
Jesus is God's son. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, why is Jesus special?
Jesus is God's son. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Happy birthday, Jesus. See you next time.
So there's your story. It's all true. Baby Jesus was born as a gift to me and you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, that really is the best story ever told. And the best part is, it's all true. I'm so happy Jesus is born, aren't you? I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! I'm gonna rip up my baby Jesus cookie, just like Mary did. Baby Jesus. Aw, so sweet. Happy birthday, Jesus! I better start decorating my cookie. I'll see you all next time. Merry Christmas!
God loved the world so much that he gave his only son, John 3:16. God loved the world so much that he gave his only son, John 3:16.
I love candy canes. Candy canes are so fun this time of year. You know, I've been in the stores and I've seen the regular candy canes, the red and white ones, but I've also seen the green ones, the blue ones, and even the rainbow ones. Today we're going to be using a red and white one, and I have something special to tell you guys. You know, a candy cane is a symbol of Christmas, but did you know that if you actually turn it upside down, it is a J? And I'm sure you guys know what J stands for at Christmas time. You're right, it's Jesus. And we want to remember that even all the fun things around Christmas, candy canes and Christmas trees and everything, the most important thing about Christmas is Jesus. So as we go through our craft today, and as you get to celebrate Christmas with your family and friends, every time you see a candy cane, I want you guys to look at it, remember the J, and remember Jesus for Christmas time. What you're going to need today is you're going to need a candy cane, and then you're also going to need some snacks. We're making a crafty snack today. And what you're going to do is get some things that are red and some things that are white, just like our candy cane. So I have some sliced pieces of string cheese. I also have some mini pepperonis for red and white. If you have a sweet tooth and want to do a sweet snack today, we have white marshmallows and we have red grapes. We also have a banana. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my candy cane and I'm going to lay it down on my paper plate. And if you need help with the markers, if you need help getting a paper plate, if you need help with the drawing or the tracing, go ahead and ask a parent or adult in your house to help you with this. And we're going to trace our candy cane and make a J on our plate. And some of you may not even need to trace it. You guys probably know your letters really well and know how to make a J. So I go ahead and trace my candy cane. Let's finish this up right here. And then I'm going to set it aside. I'm actually going to use grapes and bananas today. And so I have a banana. Did you guys know, this is a fun fact, that instead of peeling it from the top, you actually can peel a banana from the bottom. And that way the banana does not get all squishy. I don't know about you guys, but I don't like that. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and take this, lay it down, and I do have a plastic knife. Again, if you need some help, make sure you ask a parent in your house. And we're just going to take some slices of our banana. And again, this will represent the white part of our candy cane as we remember Jesus. Go ahead and slice them into thin slices. And then I have my grapes, and I'm going to go ahead and take the red and put it on top. And then I'm going to go ahead and take the white and do that. Then Then I have another red and white. You can finish this out. And again, you may have some candy around your house, some sprinkles, whatever you want to use to make your candy cane red and white, you can go ahead and do that. So now that I have my snack, every time I see a candy cane, I'm going to remember that Christmas is about Jesus. Enjoy your snack, and don't forget to eat your candy cane and enjoy that as well, kids.